Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today, there are lots of delays and not many updates other than Boca Chica and Starship. However, let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off the video, we have a tweet from SpaceX about the Anisys 2 launch. They said, standing down from tomorrow's launch of Anisys 2 to take a closer look at the second stage, swap hardware if needed. We'll announce a new target launch date once confirmed on the range. Spaceflight Now tweeted about the delay of this launch and how the company is trying to cut turnaround times. One part of their tweet says, it's the second Falcon 9 launch to be postponed indefinitely in recent days as SpaceX tries to cut turnaround times for reused rockets. Musk responded to this tweet to say, we are being extra paranoid, maximizing probability of successful launch is paramount. So, while SpaceX are trying to break records, the risk of having issues is greater. It's much better to delay launches when not ready than have the possibility for very expensive items going boom. With the small amount of SpaceX updates covered, let's check out what's been happening in Boca Chica. Starting with a few test area things, we have the walls being constructed by the launch mount. You can see that they've progressed further and now put together some scaffolding. Up next, we have an interesting area being worked on that I didn't know belonged to SpaceX. Apparently, this is an old gas well and you can see workers have begun groundwork by digging up the earth next to it. Over by the launch area, workers are continuing to work on the Starship Super Heavy launch pad. They were recently seen constructing and placing another rebar tube into the foundations. However, here you can see them popping in and out of the ground. In preparation for the long-awaited hop, which could be on the order of weeks away, SpaceX have cleared the landing pad. They've recently been doing a whole load of work over there, but they're definitely not wanting anything to get destroyed. We'll head over to the construction area now, starting with the latest work on the high bay. You can see that all four corners have been raised, but they are currently working to connect these together. Also, over at the production part of the facility, in the last video we saw workers beginning to expand the area. Whilst it's not clear what they are preparing for, here you can see the latest progress with the groundwork. Elsewhere in the yard, we have some more deliveries of some metal components. Also, the metal components we saw in a previous video arriving recently have been spotted moving. As you can see, they've been moved over near the fabrication building. Over by the windbreaker building, there is a new weather station that is being erected. Another one to add to the growing collection of weather stations around the facility. Now we will move on to Starship, starting with some pieces that have been spotted here and there. We recently saw a segment of a lower bulkhead sitting outside and you can see it's still there. Then, a little while back, we also saw a new ring stack moved outside with the name Juan. Here you can see this section also still sitting outside. Now, it looks like both of these two were destined for each other as the stack has been sleeved with the dome. They are working on this behind the tents, which we don't normally see. Also, it's not the best of SpaceX's build, so I doubt this is going to be used for a Starship. Will be interesting to see what happens with it though. Also spotted was a whole load of rings as well as some rolls of steel sitting outside. Don't think this is very new, but thought I would show it anyway. Now we have the main attraction, SN5. Again, it's delayed, but we may not have too much longer to wait. Engineers have been continuing to prepare with further work around the prototype. As expected, they've also been continuing to work underneath the tank. You can see that most recently they've been working on the ground support equipment. Just a quick look at the timelines for testing, you can see here the updated road closures. There had originally been all three dates scheduled for testing, however you can see today the 15th has been cancelled. However, tomorrow July 16th and Friday 17th look to still be on the table. For the final part of the episode we have a few more pieces of Starship. First up is the nose cone and fairing ring stack we saw in the last video over by the windbreaker. On top of the stack you can see little metal spikes which, as you can see by Jack Bayer's editing, are called lead-ins. As you may have seen in an earlier clip of the video, this nose also has a crane hooked up to it. Since then, this nose cone has been stacked. No indication as to what this fairing will be used for, but possibly SN5 or SN6. Over by this nose cone, just behind it, you can see one of the other nose cones we've seen recently. Then also inside of the onion tent is yet another nose cone under construction. Maybe soon we could see a bunch of fairing sections and potentially a full-size Starship. Finally, we have a section we saw in the last video, which is this thrust section sitting inside a tent. You can see it's still in there, but also just to the right of it, you can see another barrel section being worked on. Then we also have a fantastic shot by NSF member Nomad of the inside of one of these onion tents. You can see a whole load of thrust sections of different sizes plus what appears to be just a standard barrel section. Will be very interesting when these segments begin emerging once again, there's possibly a new Starship tank just on the horizon. As always, a massive thank you goes to Mary Boca Chica Girl for all her dedication and time spent capturing these great views. Also, thank you to Nomad for his shots and the rest of the NASA spaceflight team for their amazing work. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.